and welcome to the episode 10 of What A Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, we have quite a beefy show with a lot of things to say and a rather dramatic turn in the life of the Beatles. Let's move on with the contents then. On the 10th of January 1958, the Quarrymen had their first engagement of the year on a backup concert at the new Clubmore Hall in Liverpool. Originally, they had been booked to play on the 9th of January at the Wilson Hall, but the promoter, Charlie McBain, changed the booking. The Quarrymen featured Len Gary on T-chest bass, Eric Griffiths on guitar, Colin Hanton on drums, John Lennon on guitar and voice, and Paul McCartney on guitar and voice. Moving to 1962, we find manager Brian Epstein traveling to the Manchester's BBC headquarters today. The business at hand was to file a completed 3-page application for an audition by Variety Department that would eventually grant the Beatles their first audio audition date with the British Broadcasting Company on the 12th of February. In the evening, the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, performed at the Cavern Club in Liverpool. On the 10th of January 1963, the Beatles returned to grace a Liverpool stage after more than a month and after their Scottish tour, with an appearance at the Grafton Room, their second ever in that venue. The night was a resounding success, with record attendance for the venue. A curiosity. According to Mark Lewison, days before the performance, someone stole 100 tickets for the concert. The tickets were numbered and they were declared invalid by the organization. In 1964, the Beatles were on stage at the Astoria Cinema in London for the two houses of the 15th night of the Beatles Christmas Special. 3 years later, in 1967, between 7 p.m. and 1:40 a.m., the Beatles, George Martin and Jeff Emerick were at the EMI studios to complete further sonic experiments on Penny Lane, recording, in particular, scat singing harmonies and a hand bell, overdubbed onto take 9. On the 10th of January 1968, George Harrison kept working on the soundtrack of the film Wonderwall at the EMI's facilities in Bombay, India, between 10 a.m. and 7 p.m. local time. Camera crews filmed George at work. Reuters had 45 seconds of color footage, while BBC had slightly less. The films, silent, showed the local musicians hired by George working on the track Fantasy Sequence. Finally, in 1969, the rehearsals of the Get Back TV special and their filming reached day 7 at the Twickenham Film Studios. The day started again with Paul McCartney alone at the piano. Waiting for the other Beatles, Paul had a brief run-through of songs rehearsed in the previous days, like I've Got a Feeling and Get Back. Get Back was the focus of the work when the other Beatles arrived too, with another version of the lyrics setting the action in Tucson, Arizona. John Lennon took vocal duties on the track for one take. After that, the band moved on Two of Us, and then, during the lunch break, George Harrison left the Beatles. According to Mark Lewison, during the break, George had an argument with John in the Twickenham canteen, resulting in George quitting the band, saying, "See you around the clubs," to the others and walking away. Neither George Harrison or Ringo Starr remembered the club phrase or any disagreement with Lennon when they recounted the episode later during the anthology project. George explained the whole episode away, saying, "I thought I'm quite capable of being happy on my own, and if I'm not able to be happy in this situation, I'm getting out of here." Everybody had gone through that. Ringo had left at one point, I know John wanted out. It was a very, very difficult, stressful time, and being filmed having a row as well was terrible. I got up and I thought, I'm not doing this anymore, I'm out of here. So I got my guitar and went home, and that afternoon wrote Wah Wah. George took his car, drove home, and subsequently packed a bag and drove north to be with his parents for a few days. Ringo instead remembers. George left because Paul and he were having a heated discussion. They weren't getting on that day, and George decided to leave, but he didn't tell John or me or Paul. There'd been some tension going down in the morning, and arguments would go on anyway, so none of us realized until we went to lunch that George had gone home. George was writing more. He wanted things to go his way. When we first started, they basically went John and Paul's way, because they were the writers. But George was finding his independence, and he wouldn't be dominated as much by Paul, because in the end, Paul wanted to point out the solo to George, who would say, "Look, I'm a guitarist, I'll play the solo." The remaining Beatles exchange few comments, John Lennon infamously commenting that if he, George, doesn't come back by Monday or Tuesday, we ask Eric Clapton to play. Then they return to the soundstage and recorded a version of The Who's A Quick One While He's Away, and then an improvised angry jam, with Yoko Ono sitting on George's blue cushion, offering her signature screaming to the music. When the jam was completed, the band continued working on some of the songs, like I've Got a Feeling and Don't Let Me Down, but the tension was too high, and they eventually stopped jamming and went home. This concludes today's episode. If you like this podcast, please check www.simonmas.com/support to find ways to support it and allow me to continue working on it. Even bringing it to the attention of your friends can make a difference. In the description, you will find a link to the complete list of songs recorded during the Get Back sessions and an Amazon affiliate link with all the books that inspired me to write the podcast. Should you feel inclined to do some shopping, please follow the link. It won't cost you a penny more, and it will help paying for the continuation of this podcast. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation. Simon Mas, music you love.